This is why we can't have nice things. After a whole year of awful game releases that I wouldn't even wipe my ass with, I'm pretty sure even as a toilet paper, Kalisto Protocol would stutter on my ass. After so many sad stories, after all this war, we finally get a good-looking, polished, interesting game, Hogwarts Legacy. And I'm gonna be honest with you, Harry Potter before this, it meant absolutely nothing. But since I saw so many people talking about it, I had to at least watch the movies to get a sense of the lore. So I was also interested. Everyone was excited for the fucking game. And then the shit eaters appeared. Hogwarts Legacy isn't a game. We start off very well with a fact. No denying that this isn't a game at all. At all! It's a character test, and a lot of people are about to fail it. This woman right here broke the code. So what if you donate monthly to charity? Pfft, what the fuck is that? Any scrub can do that. Now, not buying a game that costs you financially. Now that, that is a true test of a person's integrity. God damn it. Now, the way this is written, it makes me indicate that this person thinks they're above and beyond everyone else. That their moral integrity is more well protected than a nun's pussy. But I'm sorry to break it to you. I'm gonna bet a lot of money that you uploaded this using your cute little iPhone, whose production was outsourced to China, where they pay their employees with fucking pebbles. I'm pretty sure at this point, any iPhone will contain a trace of 3% tears. Let's not forget that Apple was one of the many companies, it's not just Apple of course, that had to install anti-s**t nets on their sweatshops. But you don't give a shit about that, do you? But no, you know, it's Harry Potter that is the problem, a fucking game that is the issue. It's not the fact that she buys massively produced Nikes, where they pay like 3 cents to the fucking worker. Maybe she has a taste for the Mercedes-Benz, which used to haul the viewer's ass. Does outrage have like a validation date? So the whole thing with the Mercedes, Apple, and all pretty much 90% of the companies that we buy products off. The suffering they once caused is only a problem if it was in the past, like a long time ago. So you prefer to destroy the livelihood of hundreds of people, the entertainment of millions, because of one fucking person. Watching gaming outlets jump through rhetorical hoops to justify coverage on Hogwarts Legacy isn't surprising. How do these people function in the real world? Does this guy also get mad when CNN covers the Ukraine war? Does this man know what covering something fucking means? Now, this is only two examples of internet-filled stupidity, but you can shorten to Twitter, of course. It's the capital for dumbasses. But you can possibly imagine how happy I was when the developers, Portkey, did an absolute jigga-shad of a gamer move and just outright said no to sending keys to, or no, early access keys to Kotaku, Polygon, you know, these cesspools that call themselves game journalists.
Including some of the reactions from this gaming industry and the many outlets that did not get review codes from Warner Brothers. That was a deliberate move by WB because they knew that a lot of these outlets, the Kotakus and Polygons, were not going to review the game, they were going to review Rawling.
Of all the things that are happening in the world, this is the problem. This is where people are going to be tested. Right now, apparently there's 500,000 transphobes on Twitch. It's an amazing number. I've never seen it. And here I was thinking concentration camps could possibly be the worst thing in history. Well, now we actually got Hogwarts Legacy. I mean, come on, even people are afraid to stream the goddamn game just because of the harassment these people have been causing on others. Even a Sun Piker is scared of playing the game. Do you know how stupid you have to be to push me to defend this guy? I kind of feel bad in the sense that he does want to play the game. He says he wants to play the game, but he won't because he knows that he most likely will get a backlash. And I sort of feel bad up until the point that I remember this is the Frankenstein that he created. The audience that is going to burn him at the stake is the one that he breathes every fucking night when he streams. But everyone else who wants to play the game, just genuinely enjoy it, they're not going to be able to do so. You see people doing streams for charity, for other transgender organizations, and you still decide to bully them. Bro, friendly fire on, what the fuck is this? To people who are possibly afraid to stream or record this game, don't be afraid. This type of people don't have the most well-developed brains in the world, so they're gonna most likely forget about it after 3 days like a fucking goldfish.